Start.
My ID is 0101-162-163. Good afternoon. A few years back, I got the opportunity to interact with perhaps the greatest scientist India was ever to start with, Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam. And I posed him a question saying, "Sir, do you see any future of nuclear power in India?" The former president smiled and replied, "Son, the day is not far when nuclear power will be soon to satisfy all our needs." His answer left me quite bewildered. After all, what made him say that? So the very next day I went on the research and I found that nuclear power in India was supplying only 90.5% of all energy needs, whereas compared to coal, that is 39.3%. What made him say that? What was the base of his answer? But the very next slide made me change my mind. As you can see, coal, oil, and gas will only last for an average of 40 years from now. It's quite prevalent that we need to find an alternative source of energy to satisfy our needs. I remembered his words, "Nuclear power will soon be enough to satisfy our needs." This is the explosive power of a nuclear bomb. 10 million Kelvin of energy generated in a single reaction. A pound of uranium generates a million times equivalent energy to a pound of coal. Imagine what prospects we could have for in a country like India. Nuclear power works on two principles, that is your chain reaction and the nuclear fission. In a layman's language, I can simply explain it to you in the form of the game of dominoes, where you strike one pallet and all the others subsequently fall down. As when we come to the origin, I can just give you the outline, saying that it was Louis Lizard and Enrico Fermi who made the world's first nuclear reactor, that was the Chicago Pile 1. This gives you the present scenario of nuclear power in the world. As you can see, USA, that's the United States of America, has the most number of nuclear power plants, operational power plants in the world, that is around 100 power plants. Coming to Europe, they are widely concentrated in regions of Germany, France, and even some parts of UK. Now, coming to the most interesting part of the presentation, nuclear power in India, that is my country. At present, 5,302 watt electrical power is generated by nuclear power, that is around 3% of all energy needs in India are satisfied by nuclear energy. This is a very minimal quantity when we compare it with thermal power plants or, for instance, hydroelectric plants. But we all know the cause and pros of those particular sources. Hydroelectric power causes flooding in the nearby areas. It destroys the ecosystem. Your coal is the major cause for air pollution in the world right now. This is the future prospect of nuclear power. The energy consumption and the rate of growth is supposed to shoot up to 40,000 mega electric volts. That is nearly 70% growth in the present and future.
Time, come on, conclude.
This is the present scenario of nuclear power in India. As we all know, Dr. Homi Jehangir Baba is also called the nuclear man of India. He was the one who made the first nuclear reactor in India, that is Apsara. This is the present scenario that the Indian nuclear scientists have predicted, that it's supposed to grow to up to 7,000 watts and 8,000 in the nearby future. This is a state-wise distribution of nuclear power consumption as well as the growth in those particular areas.
Time, conclude, conclude fast.
Thank you.
Well done. Well done, well done.
Any questions?
Any question from the audience, students? There's no question, please.